We had a waffle stop. And now we are soon where we're going to take into a spa. Babe, do you know where we're going yet?
Absolutely no idea. I'm following the GPS.
Yay!
Finally here. I still don't know where it is, but yeah.
But we are, here we are.
We are at the parking lot. Hey.
We are going on the spa.
Nice place.
Welcome to Spa Retreat, Ellery Beach House.
Ta-da.
We can go to the gym, we can go to the spa, we can go to the restaurant, we can have a drink.
We can just not build a van at all.
Happy birthday, babe! Do you like it?
Just started his van in battery panic solution.
Kind of. It's not sunny enough here in Sweden anymore.
We have to leave.
Yes, we have to leave. To be fair, I'm leaving tomorrow, but
wrong direction.
Yeah, I'm on a plane, so I'm going to Norway.
Yeah, you are. So we had, as you know, we left north of Sweden. And then we went to, you got a birthday present.
Hey, that was amazing.
To check into a spa relax hotel.
Yeah.
So we checked into Ellery Beach House. Mm. And did you like it?
Yeah, I'd totally recommend you guys. If you ever in Stockholm, if you want to take some time to see the calm part of Stockholm, it was beautiful. It was super, super nice. The room was nice. It's kind of like a family. Like, you get a family feeling. Even if it's a big hotel, it's still like you get the family feeling. Mm-hmm. And you walk around in your, like, morning clothes.
Bathrobe.
Yeah. Bathrobe. And just eat breakfast and, like, drink champagne.
It's like in the middle of the archipelago, so you can still drive there. Mm. But outside Stockholm, and it's absolutely beautiful. They have like two saunas, they have like four swimming pools, I think.
Yeah.
So many different bars, relaxed places. Yeah. They had like an open fire, and then they had like relaxed beds around it, and then you didn't even have to go to the bar. You could just press a button behind you, and then the waitress came and give you your like champagne or whatever.
What? That's a big bug.
That is a big.
Anyway, she wants to go to Spain.
Yeah. So yeah, we were there. We had amazing, and then we stayed one night. We had amazing dinner and everything. We get really drunk, and then I came up. We came up to the hotel room, and I went to the toilet, and then I came out, and he was laying in bed.
I mean, I've been
very romantic.
I've been working like 16 hours a day for the last
The day before you went out, you went to bed at 4 a.m. in the morning and went up at 8. So you have to like a little bit suit yourself. I told him the day before, like, please don't stay up the whole night so we can enjoy tomorrow. No, I won't. And then he came to bed at 4 a.m. in the morning.
I needed some quality time with my friends.
Yeah. So we had like two nights, and then we have one last night now.
Yeah.
And then you're off to Norway. So tonight we're gonna have dinner with my friends.
Yeah.
And then you're off, and I'm going out to the west coast for the weekend, and then I am going down to south of Sweden, and that's where I'm gonna be around with my family and my friends, waiting for you to come back from work. And what are our plans then?
To leave Sweden.
Yeah, but where are we going? We actually talked about this. We planned this when we were at the hotel.
Yeah, like we've been pushing the plans until now because we haven't had a date of when we're gonna leave, or like how the restrictions gonna be or whatever. But now we finally made up a plan. Like, we both wanted to go to Greece, but this year we are not going to Greece.
No, we just decided that we're not.
Yeah, so we probably gonna do that when we had one van. This year is not gonna be one van.
No.
Even if we've been thinking about moving into one though.
He's trying to plan like, okay, so where can we fit your things here and your things and that and that and that. But it's like, well, we can, of course we can fit into one van. I mean, like, couple lives in smaller place spaces. Mm. Like smaller vans than I have, but so of course. But we also have a lot of toys. We also have like, yeah. Well, I don't know. We're the worst compact living. That's what me and Maya said as well. That was the first thing when I did the story. Like, should we move together? Maya, that you saw that I visited before, she just answered straight away, no, you can't fit in one van.
I mean, I don't want to give up my toys. Like, I don't want to give up the motorbike. I don't want to give up the paramotor, and I don't want to give up the surfboard.
So it's easier to give up me, you know.
I don't want to give up you. That's why you have your own van. Like, my bike cannot drive her own van.
So. Oh, mm-hmm. That's bad bike.
I know.
Okay, yeah. So no Greece, because this year as well, you're gonna keep working. So he's gonna be off work from 4 weeks, and then you're going to work for two, and then off for four around that. Which means that 2 weeks at a time I'm gonna travel alone, and yeah, so we said we have no idea, and because of the restrictions we don't know if they're gonna close borders again or not, so everything is a little bit like this. So we said, okay, let's just not push it and guess that, you know. I don't want him or me to be stuck somewhere else where we can't actually meet. So we are going back to Spain, yeah. But different places in Spain. We are going home to my place.
Yeah. Malis.
Mallorca. So we're going to take the ferry out to Mallorca.
Yeah.
And then we might take the ferry to Ibiza.
Yeah. And then back to Spain. So yeah.
Island hopping, because the only thing that we have to, or at least that I have to, but I would love to have him with me, is that from April until September I have to have the van parked in the mainland of Spain because of event weddings and birthday parties. My own birthday party, actually, so it's quite good to be there. So we decided to do some island hopping before.
Yeah,
we could easily spend 3 months in each island. Easily.
Oh yeah, I know. So and just it comes relax. Down to not enough to time yet again.
Yeah, I know, but it feels quite nice that we don't have to stress, like, you know, we're gonna be in Spain and now we know it, and now we can just relax, we can just get down there and just be around it and just relax and take it easy, because I've been so stressed, you've been so stressed.
Oh,
and
yeah,
it feels quite nice not to, you know, drive around to so many new countries at this moment, actually. Because I'm gonna have a really, really busy 3 months of work now as well, until New Year's, and it feels nice to not have to stress around, actually.
And I am actually gonna work again. I've been off work for 14 months now, and I'm actually gonna go back to working on the oil rigs in Norway. But that still means that I work for 2 weeks, and then I have 4 weeks off. So, but it's a lot of time that.
I don't think he listened to what I said, because I just explained this.
Did you?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, never mind.
So, how do you feel about going back to work then?
Okay. It actually feels great. I mean, I love my work. So, it's just because of the restrictions that I haven't been really wanted to work. So, it feels super, super nice to go back, have 2 weeks of climbing around, hanging in ropes, being on a platform, just focus on eat, sleep, and train, and
eat, sleep, train, work, repeat.
Yeah, it's gonna be good.
Yeah. Okay, so now we're gonna do you're gonna clean up your van, I'm gonna go into meetings, and then we're gonna hit the gym, we're gonna refill some water at my mom's place, and then we're going to dinner with my friends and spend the last night together, and you have to leave like 5 a.m. tomorrow morning or something.
Yeah.
And it feels so weird, like, we were apart for 2 weeks and now I've had you for 3 days, and then now you're leaving again. So yeah, very fun. Everyone that I meet is like, is your boyfriend even for real? Because no one has met him. So when we came to the gym yesterday, like, one guy's like, oh yeah, he's for real, nice to see you, not just on social media. But it's like, everyone says that, like, yeah, I promise, I haven't photoshopped him into my pictures. He is actually for real, but it's just that we haven't had time to meet any one of my friends. But tonight you're gonna meet my best friend, and that's the most important thing.
Yeah.
So yeah, so we got some stuff to do, and I think this is the end of this video. So, well, guys, have a good day, and I'll see you next week. Cheers.
Bye.
It's 4 a.m. in the morning.
Mm-hmm.
But he's leaving.
You're leaving.
Bye, babe. I'm gonna miss you again.
2 quick weeks. No worries.
Yeah. Okay. I'm ever gonna get used to. Right. You know, saying goodbye and him leaving. And I know it's gonna be like this because it starts to work now. But, and I know it's good, and I am always the one that said that. I know, I think that I would like to have a relationship where you actually don't stuck with each other completely all the time, and I know it's good for every relationship to be apart, but you know, from constantly 24/7 all the time to nothing, it's like, it's so empty. You know, you're gonna sleep alone in the van, you're gonna travel alone in the van, and it's just really empty. And now he's even leaving the country, so it feels hard. I know I'm gonna be busy with a lot of fun things anyway, but still. We had 3 days together. 3 days in 4 weeks, it's gonna be
Oh, well, it's gonna be good anyway, but yeah, we'll see. Now I'm gonna go back to bed for 2 hours. Good night, or good morning, or whatever it is.